While talking about the repricing of the global bridge asset, we discussed yesterday about remittance market and digital payments market, right? But we need to actually look at physical money in the world, that is $36.8 trillion. And the accessible money in various accounts around the globe is $54 trillion. Now we know that physical money, or the cash as we know, is gonna go away. So what's gonna happen? The physical money will actually be placed along with the accessible money in the accounts that will take it into $90 trillion. That's a huge target market. We're not even looking at the derivatives market of $544 trillion and those all other markets which we discussed in the previous one in this video. If you see value in the video, please do hit the like, subscribe and the bell notification icon to get notified about the future videos. The world is getting into a lockdown phase or a control phase. We can actually see a lot of government activities coming in to control us. And during this phase, we are actually going to look at new global bridge asset when these things are happening around the world to control us. Based on the current supply and considering the future escrow releases, we can say 100 billion is not much because just the physical cash which we are talking about here is $36.8 trillion. Now yes, I understand physical cash is not, you know, everything. It's gonna go away soon because of what all of us think about the spread of this disease. So we are gonna look at the accessible accounts. So including all of that, it's $90.4 trillion. That is huge because just the money which is in the accounts is $54 trillion. So along with that and the physical money, that's $90 trillion. Now think, the movement of money digitally for just the payment use case is so huge and unimaginable, right? When we also look at the next area, which is derivatives, it hold like $54 trillion at the bottom, and some estimate it to reach $1.2 quadrillion on the higher end. Now, if you think that's too much to target, okay, look at just the total money in the stock market along with the total money we just saw, that's $90 trillion. It is $73 trillion in just the stock markets. And what you have to understand is, I already showed you guys, stock markets are being controlled. Governments across the world is coming out and stating, you can't short this market based on your wish. We are going to control that. So what do you actually think? That's actually, I know it's bizarre, but considering that the market is topping out and most of the investors know this. So now they are to buy assets which are already overpriced? I don't think so. Do you think, you know, the smart investors will do that? No, they won't. They will actually look at undervalued assets. That's for sure. And you know, that's the time when, you know, when dollar is kind of getting overpriced and even it may go more. Say it can become a bubble, and that's the time when these assets like silver and all other assets and XRP, which is kind of, you know, already retraced 97% from the top, is becoming an undervalued asset for the investors to jump in. And it's not only those, right? The top 10 or 20 digital assets will also serve the purpose. Now think, will they go for the one supported by Chinese miners? At this aspect, when you know everyone, even the president is coming out and saying, you know, that Chinese shit. So, you know, in my perspective, I don't think so. They will actually go for the one which is supported by central banks across the world, or the governments across the world, or the regulators at least. So looking at the end note in which, you know, this article is stating, that kind of reinforces all my perspectives. Say for example, they're actually looking at this. Say for example, bitcoins and other types of cryptocurrencies may take longer time to adopt it, to be adopted, but the figure is slowly rising as businesses and other commercial practices adopt digital forms of payment. So businesses are actually coming out and using this. So you know, it's just common sense when they are trying to control over the flow of value. And which asset should be used, businesses will actually have to use something which is regulated, which is supported by the central government. Now, yes, I understand we are looking at central bank digital currencies and it's a possible option. But last time when we discussed about this, we discussed about the ECB reports in which we discussed about that central bank digital currencies are not going to be accessible for the common man directly. They will have a scalable and frictionless asset connecting the transfer between that, you know, the transfer of value. So that leads us to the ultimate payment system. So when I say the ultimate payment system, you actually have to listen to this, what the David Chaus is actually talking about here.
I'll say one thing that I think is going to be huge is micropayments. This gets a little out there for this audience maybe, but I think micropayments are going to sort of take over the world the way packet data kind of took over the world. I think that if you can make small payments very cheaply and you can make billions of them without a problem, then you don't need any, you don't need anything else. You don't need some special way to make larger payments. I will.
So from this one, it is clear that micropayments, you know, it will take the transfer of value from, you know, little value to endless value of money transfer. Now, when we actually come back to the chart of XRP and look at it, the chart is clear that it has retraced 97% from the all-time high. And in the monthly chart, you can actually see these long-wicked double bottoms. These were also present in the previous cycle as well. And we have actually detailed those in our recent videos, so I'm not going to get into that. But based on this, what you can understand is, yes, I agree that the selling volume here looks high, but as it has already retraced this much, a push higher before we see light at the end of the tunnel for the current economic situation we are in won't actually surprise me, because, you know, when things are getting like these aspects, you know, countries which were previously really well into the crypto space are being restricted to take their own opinion to do what they want, I don't think they will actually use those accessible money in their account to go in and buy more stocks. Instead, they will go to something or some assets which can be controlled by them. At least they can put that into a Ledger Nano X and keep that in their pocket. At least the government don't have the direct control over it. But still, it will be a regulated one. There is nothing illegal there, right? Guys, that's all for today, and if you guys like the content I'm providing on a regular basis, please do support the channel, hit the subscribe button, and if you like the content, do obliterate the like button.